We are seriously hooked on electricity. About 60 years ago, household electrical appliances were limited to a refrigerator, a vacuum cleaner, and, if you were lucky, a TV. Now we can't imagine our lives without a stove, dishwasher, microwave, computer, tablet, and of course the object of modern worship, a smartphone. But the problem is that all these devices emit an electromagnetic field that can fry a person and destroy their DNA, causing cancer. If you haven't fled into the woods yet, let's figure out what these electric and magnetic fields are, how they are created, and maybe it is not so scary after all. To begin with, an electric field is created due to a voltage difference. The higher the voltage, the stronger the emerging field. In our everyday life, it means that any device that plugs into a socket is a source of an electric field. Moreover, the device itself does not need to be turned on. But when you do turn it on, an electric current will run through the wires and the magnetic field will be created along with the electric field. Now there is a well-known and scary electromagnetic field around the device. To prevent household appliances from emitting an electromagnetic field, you need to unplug all devices from the power outlet. Every one of them. Your refrigerator, washing machine, stove, TV, microwave. Of course it's easier to pull the switch. Or you can watch this video to the end and be done with electromagnetic radiation. What scares people in the first place is the word radiation, because they immediately think of Chernobyl.
Not great, not terrible.
But radiation is only the transfer of energy in the form of particles or waves. And there are endless waves around us. Most of them aren't visible because from the entire known spectrum we see only this part. To the left is infrared radiation, which includes microwaves, all radio waves, and wires in houses. The further you move to the left, the longer the emitted waves and the lower the frequency of their oscillations. For example, a microwave operates at a frequency of 2.5 GHz, that is, in 1 second, 2.5 oscillations multiplied by 10 to the 9th degree occur. That's how many times per second. With that, food will certainly heat up, and the length of one wave is about 12 centimeters. By the way, few people know that the microwave does not actually heat up food, but water molecules. The thing is that each substance reacts differently to a certain wave spectrum. Some waves will pass through the water, some will be reflected, and others will be absorbed. Water absorbs waves with a frequency of 2.5 GHz. Microwaves beat up water molecules, causing them to oscillate quickly, and roughly speaking, friction makes the temperature of your food rise. And the speed of heating depends on the volume of the product. For example, a piece of chicken heats up in 20 seconds, while a kilogram will take about 5 minutes. Interestingly, a Wi-Fi router works at the same frequency as the microwave. Smartphones' frequencies depend on the generation of networks, from 800 MHz to 2.6 GHz, but with the advent of 5G, the frequencies will increase. Everything you see on the left is non-ionizing radiation. These waves are not able to disrupt the structure of the atom, which leads to the emergence of free radicals and the launch of a biochemical reaction when DNA gets broken down, which might cause cancer. These dangerous emissions include X-rays. Their wavelength varies from a 0.1 to 1 nanometer. Just a note, 1 nanometer is that many centimeters. It looks like a stream of micro, or rather nanobullets, ready to disturb the atoms themselves. And with these, you should really be on your toes, as with gamma rays.
We're good!
Notice only these waves start causing dangerous radiation, the one that comes to mind in the first place. By the way, that is why there is a number of restrictions, such as do not get X-rayed more than once every 6 months, and it's even more strict for children. So the world is shrouded in waves of different lengths and frequencies. The source of wave radiation can be both the Earth and the Sun. People have divided the frequencies into those that can disrupt the structure of DNA and those that have enough power just to raise body temperature. But in fact, it is not only a matter of frequency. You could even say that there are no dangerous frequencies. There are dangerous doses, or power. You remember that a Wi-Fi router operates at the same frequency as a microwave, but for some reason we do not heat up the chicken on top of it. That's because the power of the router is 0.1 watts, and the microwave can use up to 1,000 watts. That is, the router is 10,000 times weaker, although it works at the same frequency as the microwave. And the power consumption of other household appliances was measured 20 years ago, as reported by the World Health Organization. I will leave a link in the description box where you can see what is the strength of the electric field of an iron, refrigerator, electric stove, and other items. It also contains data on magnetic fields. For the most part, everything is safe at a distance of 30 centimeters, and with every centimeter, the effect is significantly reduced. For example, let's take a microwave. Move 50 centimeters away from it, and the amount of its radiation will be almost halved. I'm not talking about the strict permitted limits in Russia and the international ones. By the way, we discussed this in a previous video about cell towers. It's got details on the safe distance, should you worry if the tower is built on the roof of your building, as well as information on a very important experiment with mice. You know where to find the link. But people are still concerned about the influence of electromagnetic fields, even at low frequencies, coming from things like refrigerators, Wi-Fi routers, or mobile phones. And rightly so, because electricity has flooded our homes relatively recently. Many people blame electrical appliances for symptoms such as headache, anxiety, depression, nausea, tiredness, and loss of libido. But here is what World Health Organization has to say on this topic. Let me quote their stance on it. In the area of biological effects and medical applications of non-ionizing radiation, approximately 25,000 articles have been published over the past 30 years. Based on a recent in-depth review of the scientific literature, the WHO concluded that current evidence does not confirm the existence of any health consequences from exposure to low-level electromagnetic fields. Of course, you can find a study where phone users report problems with ears, teeth, headache, sleep disturbance, and fever. But this sample includes only 12 subjects. People were just reporting results about themselves. People who tend to forget, downplay, exaggerate, because we are not robots. For instance, I'm actually a skeleton. And most importantly, there wasn't a clear correlation even in these 12 answers. For example, one subject had problems with ears from making 800 calls, while the other had no issues after calling 20,000 times. But you can also find a more serious study where 4,000 users of mobile devices were compared with a control group of 5,000. It turned out that there was no obvious connection between the development of brain tumors and how strongly the subjects were exposed to radiation. However, there are certain gaps in the knowledge of biological effects which require further research. In fact, it's very difficult to measure the real impact of various devices on our lives, because ideally, it would be necessary to produce 1,000 clones and put them in the conditions we live in, which include a contaminated environment, meat stuffed with antibiotics, alcohol, smoking, sedentary lifestyle, stress, but without electrical appliances. Or vice versa, you would need to irradiate them constantly and with different doses. By the way, that experiment with mice in a video about cell towers showed exactly that. What is undoubtedly clear right now is that in the next 5 to 10 years, no harm will come from household radiation. And now people are thinking about how to evaluate what the effect is going to be in 30 to 50 years, but I offer a compromise. You can do a few things that won't bother you much, and you won't need to wear a tinfoil hat for that. First, keep all your PC devices, Wi-Fi, monitor, tower, 20 to 30 centimeters away. Second, if the microwave or oven is on, take a step back from it. Do not press your genitals against it. Third, when you call someone, bring your phone close to your ear only when you start hearing the beeps, because your phone works at peak power when the connection is being established. Or use headphones, maybe even wireless ones. Most likely you have already been doing that, and these things are actually enough. So, do not keep the router on your lap, do not stick your head into the working microwave, go to bed at least before 12 p.m. and you'll be fine. This is it for today, and I'm Bonyright.